Hey guys, today I'm going to be reviewing Smart Sweets. Basically, when I first saw them, Smart Sweets had like two flavors, sour and sweet, but now they have like these Sour Patch Kid thingies and also these like red fish. I mean, they're a company that makes low sugar gummy candies. And so today I'm gonna be trying the sour gummy bears. You can find Smart Sweets in stores at Whole Foods and other specialty markets, or you can get them online. I got these at Whole Foods. They're like, for this little bag of 1.8 ounces, it's like $2.50 or $3.50. I mean, these things are expensive. And so I like to treat them as an occasional treat, like when I just need something gummy. You know, other than that, I can make do with like a Fat Bomb or something else, but these really do fill a void that no other product out there does. Okay, so we have Smart Sweets. It says 3 grams of sugar per bag. So I mean, like there's legit sugar in here, but it says kick sugar, keep candy. High in fiber, free from artificial sweeteners, dairy, soy, and lactose free, peanut and tree nut free, free from artificial colors, naturally flavored. And there are 4 flavors in here: raspberry, apple, lemon, and peach. All right, the ingredients. Prebiotic soluble fiber from tapioca, chicory root fiber, gelatin, lactic acid, citric acid, rice flour, malic acid, fumaric acid, natural fruit flavor, fruit and vegetable juice for color, coconut oil, stevia leaf extract, carnauba wax. Now I know that they changed their formula recently because some of these have carrageenan in them, like these for instance have carrageenan, and I know that they changed their formula to remove it, but these are the ones that are currently in stores. I'm not sure when those new ones are rolling out, but it doesn't appear as if the sour gummy bears have carrageenan. Okay, so the nutrition facts. For one bag, 90 calories, zero fat, 35 grams of total carbs. So like, just lots of total carbs here. 28 of those are fiber. So that brings us down to 7 net carbs. There are no sugar alcohols or anything. There are 3 grams of sugar, but overall this bag is gonna run you 7 net carbs. And I mean, that's still high, but once again, gummy candy like this is really one thing you could be missing on the keto diet. So like, you know, maybe on a splurge day, just have you 7 net carbs worth of gummy bears. Okay, so before I eat these, I'm going to test my fasting blood sugar. All right, my fasting blood sugar is 89, which is really high for me, but honestly, it is still quite early in the morning, so maybe it just hasn't, you know, settled all the way down from sleep. The only thing I've had today are a few sips of water, so we'll be starting with 89 and see where it jumps from there. Okay, so I'm gonna open up these sour gummy bears and give them a taste. Okay, here's what they look like. They are just bears covered in some sort of sour sugar like dusting. Tart, chewy, gummy, exactly what I would expect from a gummy bear if I'm gonna be spending 7 grams of net carbs on it. I mean, yeah, this'll do. Did you like gummy bears pre-keto? Like I loved Haribo Gold gummy bears. Like those were my jam. So like, if I can have something like this whenever I get the hangry, like, I'm okay with it. So here's how many you get in a pack. I mean, it's 50 grams worth. It's pretty decent. But like, this just has to be something that you really need or have a craving for. Otherwise, I'm not sure if I'm spending 7 grams of net carbs on this. And I'm definitely not spending 35 grams of total carbs. But I will sacrifice for the sake of this experiment. And I'm gonna eat these, and I'll be back in an hour to check my blood sugar, and then 2 hours to test the final results. All right, it has been an hour, so let's see what's going on. Okay, 149, I'm disgusted. Am I in a diabetic coma? Am I in shock right now? Nope. I'm testing this again. Nope. Okay, see, this one says 175. I'm starting to question everything. I don't understand. I don't understand what's happening. Either I'm dying right now, or maybe my blood glucose monitor is wigging out. I'm gonna test it again. Third time's the charm? Yeah, I mean, this one says 166. Like, all I can tell you guys is that I'm never eating these things again. I don't know what's happening. Like, even if we just go with 149, was that what it was, 140? Even if we go with 149, that was what, like a 60 point jump? Can I do math? Hold on. Yeah, like 60 points. No. Like, this is the highest I've ever seen my blood sugar. Like, I'm gonna go test on the Keto Mojo just to like make sure that this isn't broken. Yeah, so I mean, I'll be back in an hour, but like, nope. Okay, the Keto Mojo says 114. Like, I'm all over the place. Am I even gonna post this video? I don't know. Like, I have no idea what's happening. Just for fun, I'm gonna do my ketones. Yeah, like 0.1, like, I don't know what's going on here, but I don't like it. Okay guys, it's been 2 hours, and seeing as I have absolutely no idea what's going on, I'm gonna test with my blood glucose monitor just to see the relative change, and then I'm gonna test my glucose with my Keto Mojo once again. Yeah, it says I'm at 134, so I mean, that is a drop from the 149 and the 170 that it was, but like, still pretty high. So that's about a 40, 45 increase on this monitor. Now let me try my Keto Mojo. All right, and 109. So as we can see, I mean, these differences are pretty significant. At least it shows a decrease on both of them, but like, I don't know what's happening, but regardless, I can say that I probably won't be integrating Smart Sweets into my diet. Like, they're good, don't get me wrong, but I just really don't like eating that much fiber. It does tend to have larger impacts on your blood glucose. I mean, it's good for an occasional snack, and also with the expense, it's just not something I have to have part of my everyday life. Do you like Smart Sweets? Have you tried them and tested your blood sugar? Are you still alive afterwards? Like, I don't know. Like, I have no idea what's happening here, but it's just too much fluctuation all around. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, Watch Autumn Keto. I make weekly meal preps, weekly What I Eat Wednesdays, monthly weigh-ins, monthly Keto Crate unboxings, and the occasional product review and recipe. You can also find me on Instagram and Facebook at Watch Autumn Keto. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.